We have one more award to give, and that is to Representative Chippendale. As it was written, one had to be a full-time student in order to be eligible. And thanks to Representative Chippendale, we actually have an amendment that was made to the bill to allow students with disabilities to attend part-time and still be eligible for the Promise Grant, which is very important because it's an obstacle for many individuals with disabilities to trying to get higher education. Myself, some people know that during my first year of law school, I actually had a rupture in my small intestine due to Crohn's disease. And in order to catch up, I went did not lose all the credits I earned. I was able to switch part-time thanks to the dean of students being very understanding. So I know that, you know, there are times, you know, people with disabilities, they can get there, they can do the work, they can earn the degree, they can get the job, but their symptoms needs to be an accommodation in order to help the person to cross that finish line. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Elizabeth, and of course, Bob, and the commission for everything that you all do. You know, while it was the progression of my own physical disability in 2010 that sort of nudged me towards running for politics, I never really imagined that I would be working on disability-related issues. But it was after the Promise program had been passed, the Promise Scholarship, that some constituents of mine reached out to me and said, well, hey, seems to be a little bit of a shortcoming here. And so with a lot of help from Bob and all the folks in the community who deal with disabilities, whether they're physical disabilities, developmental disabilities, hidden disabilities, or otherwise, helped me to come up with the right language. And by working through amendments, when the Promise Scholarship was put into law permanently, I ensured that that language was inserted in there so that all students, regardless of their disabilities, would be able to take advantage of that. And then furthermore, when the HOPE Scholarship came along in this past year, I was equally as dogged in ensuring that that language was in there as well. We still have a lot of work to do. We still have some handicapped parking spots around the building that we need to get boosted up because it's hard for folks with disabilities to get into the State House for great events like this. I'm very honored to be receiving this. I'm happy that the commission does the work that they do, and I'm happy that so many people are here to recognize it. I thank you all from the bottom of my heart.